What are the most important stakeholders in your project?
Well, the most important stakeholders differs from stage to stage, from my experience, especially in a North South Line project. When I started off working on the project in 2009, I would say that the most important stakeholders were the people living close to the construction site, the press, and technical experts in the field of civil engineering. And in the present stage, where we are starting off with the commissioning of the North South Line, I would say that the future operator and the future asset owner are the most important stakeholders.
Did you face any problems or challenges, including these stakeholders in the project?
Yeah, when I started working on the North South Line project in 2009, it was a couple of months before that there were two large incidents on one of our construction sites, causing houses to settle. And that combined with the frequent budget overruns in the previous years and the schedule delays, caused a lot of distrust in the project organization. And at that moment in time, it was the question if the project could be continued. So we had to regain the trust of the general public to influence that decision in a positive way.
How did you manage to do so? Because I think in the meantime, the situation has changed, right?
Well, yes, it has changed, fortunately. Well, the thing is, you just build up relationships and start real dialogue with people and pay interest. The thing I noticed from colleagues is that we find it very hard as project managers or technicians to ask really open questions and to start a real dialogue and be really interested in the stakes of somebody else. And if you do so, you don't have to agree on everything, but there is a kind of mutual understanding. And just so we just started conversation.
And can you give a really specific example of that?
Yeah, well, we had to come up with preventive measures to avoid new settlements of houses along the construction site. And we chose for a freezing technique, and you need a lot of equipment for that. And it's packed in this case in six large sea containers. And we have a very long construction site, about 300 meters long. And we had to put it either on the north side or on the south side. But you can imagine that people living on the north side are in favor of putting it on the south side and the other way around. And if we would have made a choice as project organization, we would have encountered a lot of criticism from both parties. So what we did is organize a workshop and put in the question, well, where do we place these six containers? And asked both parties, the north people living on the north and the south, to give some advice. And they got in a real dialogue, and they found out during that dialogue that there are no easy answers, that there are only bad choices and less bad choices, so to speak. So in this case, so we organized that we were not in the middle of the criticism, but that they really started the dialogue amongst themselves.
Okay, and to what I understood, they really felt as having a say in finding a solution.
And
realize it's not that straightforward.
Yeah, and that's something where many project managers are afraid that if they come up with a solution, it's going to cost a lot of money and the scope is will be enlarged. To my experience, it almost always are only small changes which has a huge impact. But you only find out what to do if you start a real dialogue.
Is there anything you could recommend to your colleague project managers to do if it's about stakeholder management or stakeholder engagement?
Well, just include them in your project. Try to make them a part of it. As project managers, we like to build fences around our project to prevent scope creep and scope changes. Well, in the end, it's a very sensible strategy to include people, and then you will see that you maybe even minimize the kind of scope changes and the amount of scope changes and scope creep.
Thank you.